And yes, here we are, Espresso Sesh, Best Frequencies Forever, episode 89 with Elettrodomestico in the house. Welcome, guys. How's it going?
Buongiorno. Bye.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno. So, welcome. It's a pleasure to have you guys here. Have you guys here presenting your new band, your new material. You have a release coming up. When is going to come up the release?
Officially October 20th.
October 20th. Okay, so in like 10 days, yeah. Like something like that. And the West Coast tour also coming up. So let's introduce, probably you don't need the introduction, Jane Wiedlin from the Go-Go's.
Yes. Hi, everybody.
Hello. Welcome to have you here. You've been like in the, you're a rock star. Officially, no?
Huge.
We gotta say.
Huge.
Like the band sold 7 million copies.
Yeah.
It's something like that, no? It's,
you too got, bad I spent all that money, huh?
I know. I didn't see any of those. I know. It's okay. It doesn't matter. So you've been like, there's so much to talk to you about music, like, because from the 80s, from the early 80s, the first album was The Beauty and the Beat, 81, no?
That's right.
Probably was January 1st. was released like right away, like 81, and so since then you've been like in the music industry, in the music business.
I know, right?
I know.
Well, since 1978, so next year is 40 freaking years I've been doing this.
And you're looking fantastic, huh? So you know, like.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So since then, this is like a brand new project. Elettrodomestico.
Yes, with my partner Pietro Straccia.
Pietro Straccia.
You pronounce that really well.
Pietro Straccia. Yeah, Elettrodomestico. Yeah, I'm here for that. Yeah. Okay. So this is like a new project, brand new. So this we just premiered one song. I mean, it's not premiered, but you know, we just played Aloha.
Mm-hmm.
Is you got three singles out?
A single every 2 weeks is our goal.
Okay. Cool. And this project was born when you guys met, no? Like, we guys, how is the project? How is started?
Well, there was, I met Jane because I was recording at her house. She had a recording studio in her basement, and I was recording the solo album that you were part of in the beginning, and you actually sang on it.
Yeah.
He was at the sing-along.
Yeah, I was at the sing-along. I was at the sing-along, yeah.
I was at the sing-along, okay.
So that's where that's where we met, and a few years ago, in occasion of David Bowie's death, Jane had written
last year.
You're right. You know, she wrote lyrics based on his death, and she was very affected by it. We were both big fans, so we started writing music together in that way, and right away we just had a lot of songs, and they just all came into fruition. We decided to start recording them, and then we finished recording them, and
we thought we better make a band.
Let's make a band.
Now we have a record. We should be a band.
And all we had a bunch of our friends.
We kind of did it backwards.
Yeah, we did it backwards.
Most people form a band and then they like write songs and then they make a record. We did it upside down.
Yeah, we're just taking it a step at a time. You know, it's like we had songs, we recorded them, then we were like, let's make some videos. We have a lot of great friends that are into visual arts that helped us make beautiful videos for each song. So we have 10 videos for 10 songs, and we're slowly sharing them, and now we're going to play some shows.
And we're super famous already.
Cool, yeah, you guys have seen, you guys been in Italy touring like all the way, no?
We're
like,
huge over there.
Huge over there, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah.
We played to crowds of more than a dozen.
Yeah, no, I seen it. You guys have like a nice video out on YouTube, like how Elettrodomestico became famous in Italy. Yes.
Pietro made that. Yeah, it's nice. Documentary. Because,
yeah, you guys played like proper venues, like households and
kitchens,
like dance in the Alps. So it was great. No,
well,
like,
before we left, we decided we'll play for anyone that asks us to play.
Okay, yeah.
And so that meant, literally, you know, people's houses. You know, we went on the streets and played. We played some proper venues. So we just, any chance we had to play the music, we did it. And audience of one or more.
You know, like all the whole project looks like very spontaneous. No, like you guys started like spontaneously. I think you were just like sending along like back and forth lyrics, something like that.
Yeah, because I was living in Hawaii and he was in Oakland. So we weren't even together when we were writing last year.
Yeah.
Okay. But we just kept doing it. And I love the songs. So we just kept writing more and more.
And, spontaneously, like the band created, you guys created the band, you made out a record, and you guys are like going on tour. Like West Coast tour is starting like next week, something like that, with the record release. So, you know, like it's a great story, you know, something like out of spontaneity, you know, like from a rock star like you, no, like, you know, there is still like passion in music.
Oh, yeah.
And there is still like discovering, like, I mean, Pietro, we hosted him like, was like a year ago with his project Epic. No,
yeah. Yes.
So Pietro is very talented.
He's wildly talented.
Yeah, well,
that it was funny that time that we met last time. We had just recorded one of the songs, Rabbit Stew. And it was with, and I was, it was like a demo, and I was singing it, and we played it actually here.
Yeah, probably we played it. Yeah, yeah.
But I was like, hey, this is one song that we just came up with, and then you know, months later, we had a whole album full of stuff.
And you guys have a show coming up at the Independent in San Francisco.
That's
you guys
right.
are headliner on the. October 23rd.
Headlining.
October. It's Monday, October 23rd at the Independent.
At the Independent.
It's going to be our first show in San Francisco in like 4 or 5 months. So it should be a big fun party. We're going to have a lot of friends over. And so.
Yeah, actually, you know, like we should promote this show. If anybody can share the live video, if you're listening on the video. You want to share it? You're going to give us, you give away a ticket or two?
Oh, sure. Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
Yeah. How do they win a ticket or two?
Yeah, they should share the video. We have on live. We are live on the Facebook thing.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. So you know, Elettrodomestico playing October 23rd.
Yeah, I'm looking up all the dates because Pietro has them memorized, but I don't.
Okay.
Yeah, Monday, October 23rd in San Francisco at the Independent.
Yeah.
And then we're also playing in Seattle, Portland, Sacramento, Santa Cruz, San Diego, and Los Angeles. We're going from the top of the country to the bottom of the country.
Yeah, it's a good way to let the West Coast know about Elettrodomestico.
Yes.
So, why this name, Elettrodomestico?
She chose it.
I think it's a great name, no?
I was trying to learn Spanish because I thought I was going to move to Mexico. And my sister made me all these flashcards with common Spanish words on it. And one of the words was Elettrodomestico. And I was like, shit, that is the coolest word. I love that word. Yeah. And I said to Pietro, look at this word. And he's like, oh, yeah, in Italian, it's Elettrodomestico. And I was like... Oh, that's got to be the name of the band, which is, for Italians, it's really easy, but for everyone else, they're like, what? It's kind of hard, so we just call ourselves Ed or ED, which is kind of funny, because it's also like erectile dysfunction. But we don't care!
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's an acronymous, no? ED can be also like Ed, Dallas, whatever, no? Like,
it's right. Alex, Mr. Ed, the talking horse.
Yeah, you know, so...
Mr. Ed.
I think you guys have a cool logo with the plug outside, and you're keeping in the... Cool. And the music, it's like this kind of like dream pop, psychedelic, with like a light electronic in... But with a rock attitude, no? So it's,
totally.
Let's play another song. I mean, talking is great, no? Like, sure. But we should let the music speak for itself.
Sure.
Good idea.
Yeah, we just played. I mean, you guys have a test pressing of the record, no?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Shall we play this? Or I got line up. I got line up. Rabbit Stew, the official video.
Oh,
yeah.
Sure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You can play, we can play this one, and let's go back then.
So that's the first song we wrote together, and it's the first song on the record.
Cool, yeah. So, you know, it's an introduction, no?
Yeah.
Of the band. So let's let the music speak for itself. Elettrodomestico ad Espresso Sesh, best frequencies forever. Let's listen to Rabbit Stew. And one, and two, and one, and two, three. Yes. that was Rabbit Stew, your first single, your first song created together. Nice video, guys. Like, you always play with the gender bender thing, and you guys dress up, and also the name of the album is If You Are a Boy or a Girl, no?
Yes.
Yeah, so, you know, and I think works very well, because you guys are kind of, even visually, you guys complement each other, no? And... No.
He's a pretty one. Pretty. I'm smart.
Okay. Okay. That works. No. Yeah. Good. Yes. And so there was the guy Sedlec. No.
Sekdak.
Bryce Felici. Another Italian.
He,
yeah.
He directed the Rabbit Stew video and the Bliss video as well.
Which is going to come out. It's going to come out in a few days.
I mean, you know, like, there is some creativity among Italians, no? There are some creative. No,
very
creative people. A few of them. You got to find them.
Handsome and creative.
Yeah.
Just a little bit.
I keep things, you know, like, it's, we came from the land of the poets, the saints, and the navigators, no?
Yes.
So, you know, we gotta do some creativity. Also, we
invented everything.
We invented the word Elettrodomestico. It's a pretty Italian word. Cool. So you guys are gonna release like one video every 2 weeks.
That's the goal.
That's the goal.
Mm-hmm.
So the whole album is gonna be like on the video.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. And you guys are gonna collaborate with like local artists doing the video.
Yeah, we've already done that.
Yeah. We're missing. Maybe one.
Yeah, we have one song that needs a video.
Ah, okay. So you guys are, you got everything stored, like ready to release. Like,
yeah.
We're going to pop them out like babies.
Pop them out like babies, like mushroom. Okay, cool. Yeah, cool. I see. No, this is great. No, like a band that creates out of passion driven with like music professional, you know, and you know, from different generation of musician. That's great. That's fantastic.
Well, and we just had a lot of friends that understood the project and want to be part of it, so that they absolutely helped us, you know, create the visuals for this, and so it's a group effort, definitely. And definitely Bryce from, you know, Sekdak, he started that. Molly made the video. We have Gooch from that made the Mail Order Bride video. So everyone participated. We have Chrissy Dew that made the Nightblind videos. Really cool stuff. These are all local artists that, you know, their main means is probably something else, you know, in photography or art, and they decide to make videos for us.
It's good because, you know, combining the different, you know, creativities, not the different elements. Are you guys going to have some, like, video feature on the show at the Independent? By any chance?
That'd be a good idea.
Yeah, probably.
Let's say again, like, if you share this Facebook live video, we're going to give away...
The first two people that share the
video,
right?
Yes. So, you know, ticket for Elettrodomestico headlining the Independent on October
20th. Or if you're in a different market, if you're in Seattle or Sacramento or Portland or Los Angeles or San Diego.
We could give you a ticket to that.
Yeah, so, you know, I'm telling you. So
if you look, you can find us on Electro Band on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, right?
And yeah, YouTube.
YouTube.
If you subscribe to YouTube, then you'll be the first to get sneak peeks of videos before we even release them. Because we just do like a soft release on YouTube usually, and then we'll officially release it. So the people who are on the subscribe people are gonna get it.
If you pre-order the album, you get Pietro's phone number.
All right, yeah. So, you know, there are many reasons too. Yeah. And for any question related to the band, like, you can like write it down on the Facebook feed, because it's pretty right away. So if you have any question for Pietro or Jane or, you know,
or
me as well, you know, like, yeah, that's, you know, how to do it. Yeah, you guys brought some. Instruments over there, you're ready to play live.
We are.
It's a tiny studio, no? But it's great to have live music. So what do you guys think? Let's play another song from the record, probably from the record itself, while you guys set up. And then we do some live.
Okay.
Yeah,
because you're listening to Espresso Sesh every Tuesday, 2 to 4 on BFF.fm.
Where's that sounds like somebody's farting. What is that?
No, yeah, it wasn't that. No,
it's a...
What is that?
I want to play Stop Drop Solo from it's...
Like mint condition.
I haven't opened it yet. I hope it works. It's one of those... It's the test press.
Yeah, so they send you four of those, no?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Like, but there could be... It could be, like, not working, but I'm sure it works.
Oh, I'm sure it works. Yeah. And it's...
This is like a nice feeling when you like unwrap a record.
Like Christmas.
I love it. Like better than Christmas because it's music, no? And there are the music makers right here. So, you know, like I feel like a kid in a candy store, like you say. All right. Look how beautiful it is, like this test press.
Yeah.
All right.
It's all perfect.
Look how beautiful.
Does it have that new vinyl smell?
These are fabricated. They're made in the Czech Republic, and we made sure that they have like the highest grade.
Cool. Yeah.
Well, we were just in the Czech Republic.
I know.
Last month we were in Prague.
Oh, okay.
And we played in the square, the giant square.
I think I saw the video of you guys.
Yeah. We actually got money. People were throwing money.
Made like 65 cents.
Or to us.
And you know, this is great, no? Because you know what, like, people don't know, like, there is like a living legend of like music playing, basking in the street.
A living legend.
I mean,
thanks.
It's very nice for you to say that. You know,
they had no idea where we were just dressed up really funky, and just people just started taking pictures of us because we looked weird. So
okay, yeah, and they didn't know. They had no idea. So which song is?
Let's say first song of B.
First song of B, and if you guys can introduce this song,
the Stop Drop Solo.
Stop Drop and Swallow. Okay, this one is about how we're all being drugged and sedated through things by the government, like the internet, and then booze, and the Kardashians, and...
Mind control.
TV.
Mind control.
Mind control by the government. And we have to rise up and fight it.
Yes, you are... Especially these days, no? Especially these days.
Especially these days.
By being brotherly to your fellow brother and sister.
And other stuff, too.
All right, so let's listen to this. So let's send them again, please.
Stop. Drop and Swallow.
Elettrodomestico, BFF.fm.
Okay.
And there was Stop, Drop and Swallow by Elettrodomestico from their upcoming If You Are a Boy or a Girl album. And now I see Elettrodomestico is ready to perform some song. Yes.
We are going to play the song Bliss.
You're going to play the song Bliss, okay. Live, BFF.fm, Elettrodomestico.
Dangerous friends, my friends, keep changing like a non-stop turnstile. Not so on the width of the breadth of that smile. I would not sign up for this. Thought I was chasing my bliss. That cat, meow, 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 is a harbinger of doom.
My friends, blah, blah, blah.
In every room,
this house.
Take out the trash, now I gotta crash.
I'm not sold.
This was supposed to be a deal.
Says cash. I was not prepared
for this.
Said you would be mad with me soon.
I thought
I was chasing
my bliss.
You'd be just settling.
I thought
I was chasing my bliss. But who made their bed? Yeah, you. And now comes the time to lie, lie, lie in.
And that's what you get for your folly. Work on your poker face, dolly, dolly, dolly.
I was not prepared. I was chasing.
I
said you would be chasing.
No, I
did not sign up.
But
said you would be magnificent.
I
thought I was chasing. Chasing my bliss.
Who? Elettrodomestico live. There was Bliss. Yeah.
Bliss.
Cool. You guys can talk also in on those mic.
Oh, okay.
Because they are hooked up as well. Yeah, cool. So this is like a little preview of what you guys gonna do in your West Coast tour. Huh?
Well, there we have a special. We have two special guests joining us on stage for this whole tour.
Okay.
Don Richardson and Joe Gore will be playing respectively bass and drums.
Okay, no, I say there is like a little intimate preview for the Espresso Sesh radio show. No, yeah. We have, you see, as you can see, the space is limited.
Yes.
But, you know, like a duo, trio is perfect. Yeah. So, you know, there are going to be even more musicians like on the live show.
Yeah.
Cool. And the formula is great, like the Elettrodomestico music, like it's like upbeat, as like what are your like influences, like on the, like when you guys recorded this album, no, what you were listening to, like?
I know, I was thinking a lot about Devo, especially on that song Bliss that we just played. I really wanted like the kind of angular, jagged kind of stuff going on.
We would take every song that we were recording, we'd approach it differently, and as Jane was saying, this particular song had this like angularity, and we're like, yes, let's think about Devo, but just more as like a thought behind it, not necessarily taking any particular part of that music, but just as that sentiment, that kind of aesthetic,
the feeling
of it, and making it our, you know, our own.
And then what other kind of influences do we have?
Well, there's like for me personally, there's a lot of, you know, pop music, even from Italy. You know, a lot of the harmonies that we do together is, you know, we're a sucker for harmonies. So
yeah,
we're,
totally.
You know,
coming all the way from the bel canto, no,
exactly.
Like.
Oh, I think we thought a lot about ABBA and Mamas and Papas and kind of bands from the past that had like really like glorious harmonies, and we really strove for that because a lot of times these days you don't hear a lot of harmony.
Yeah.
And I think it's really kind of our sound is the way our two vocals sound together.
Yeah, it's good because also you guys, like I said before, complement each other and like play along with harmonies, like vocal harmonies, and and kind of like find this common ground in the vocal, like in the vocal tone. So
no, it's like I think we're equally as surprised as how the vocals work together, and we're just playing along with that. We're each bringing something that makes it.
Remember, we got in an argument once because I was like, "Where's Pietro's vocals? There's no Pietro on this song." And it turns out he was totally on the song and really loud, but we blended so well, I couldn't hear him separated from my voice.
A unique voice. I mean,
that's
our two
so
vocals
cool
together
when that happens.
A third type of voice.
Yeah. The Elettrodomestico voice. No, yeah. Or ED, like
ED. Erectile dysfunction.
Erectile
bitches.
Yes. You guys want to play another song while you like set up and let's do it. Like it's,
This one I'm just gonna play tambo on.
Okay.
This one's called Mail Order Bride.
Mail Order Bride. That is the last video you guys released, no?
That's right, yes. And we did that video in San Francisco at the Oasis nightclub, which is like a legendary nightclub. And they were doing a run of a live version of Three's Company, and they allowed us to use the set. So we had like this set that's virtually identical to the TV set for Three's Company that we were able to use for our little story about this this married couple that we just created, and we created all these little scenarios. It's a neat video. Maybe
it's a very nice video. I like it.
I like
also,
it very much.
Like you guys are multi characters, and
I get to dress up like a guy again, which I love doing.
So you guys are playing Mail Order Bride
live
at BFF.fm Espresso Sesh Elettrodomestico in the house. All right.
Woo! Turn the drums up, please.
Can it be that no one else is you? to us with the fairy tales of Jesus, promising good times ahead. For we are the dead, never leaving my side. I may know the bride, my sweet bride. Do it, do it. Why do I do? Why don't you show your face? I try and try. Where you're too deep inside, where your place you can hide. And Lord, come with grace, I could never get to that
Elettrodomestico, live BFF.fm, mail order bride, the last video you guys released, nice, okay, good, nice, like people, where is the music is rocking out, where is everybody, these guys, everybody, making it happen, okay, let's thank Amanda for the donation. And thank you. Dario got a ticket for the independent. Dario, he was sharing the video, so if you want to share the video,
thank you, Dario.
To get a pair of tickets for the show at the independent Elettrodomestico.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be on the 23rd. So you guys gonna have the record available, no, over there.
The actual vinyl won't be printed by that day, but we're gonna have downloads. We're gonna have yes.
Okay,
downloads and T-shirts.
And yeah, T-shirts. Okay, cool. Like, yeah.
Little backstage passes with our with our codes on it.
Cool.
Yeah. Download codes.
cool. And so you, wow, guys, I would like to let you play another song, no? But no, let's have a break first.
Sure. Okay.
I was asking you guys to bring some music that was influential for you.
Oh, sure.
And
can we grab something like off the internet?
Yeah.
I forgot to.
Okay, definitely. No, you can also answer. No, I don't like music. You know, like, I don't listen to that. You know, like, what is the music? No, No worries. The show is about Elettrodomestico, no? But in order to understand where Elettrodomestico comes from,
okay,
we need to. We like to know, like, what are the influences?
Okay.
And also, I would like to know, like, what kind of music make you wanna play music? No, you know, there was something. There's some, like, kind of like a ignition, no fire, like something that you listen to when you're a kid and say, like, wow, I wanna do that. I wanna be like that. I wanna play like that. Something like that. Yeah, you think about it. There is no rush. There is no rush about it. I'm gonna play another song out of. You got the test press, so
yes.
What else can I play out of this?
Let's play like one that we never played. Let's play Nightblind.
Yeah.
We'll play Nightblind, and then we'll talk a little bit about punk rock.
Okay, so let's play which song in which side,
the
please?
The last song on the second side.
No.
It's the third from last.
It is?
Yeah, because there's one, two.
Oh, I was thinking the next night. I'm confused. We have two songs with night in the title.
Okay, so it's going to be the third from the last. Alright, Espresso Sesh. You're listening to Espresso Sesh. Best frequencies forever.
I can't see in the dark.
That was Nightblind, out of If You Are a Boy or a Girl album, coming up October
20th. Yes.
Elettrodomestico. So what about, like, I was asking Jane about, like, some influential stuff, and you pull out Edition of You by Roxy Music.
Yes, when I was a teenager, well, first I fell in love with David Bowie, and then I fell in love with Roxy Music, and, oh, man, what a band. I think a lot of people know Roxy Music because of their, I think it's their eighth album, Avalon, which is when they were all, like, kind of smooth and sophisticated and stuff, but their early albums are super chaotic, super crazy musical, because they were all great musicians, and they're just weird, weird, but brilliant songs. I will never get over how great that band is. So
yeah, great element. Brian Ferry, Brian Eno, no?
Yeah, so, what a combination.
Yeah, so let's listen to this edition of You.
Yeah. What a combination.
So we're